great. Thank you. Thomas Sensei, what's your feeling?
It's a mixed feeling. I agree with Leah Sensei that up to quite recently, the different Aikido organizations, national ones or style-oriented ones, were separating from each another. And there was a tendency to for the top teachers to keep the flock under their guidance and not to allow that they are going to another one and looking for other interpretations of Aikido. And I think this is, in a way, it's vanishing. It's not completely away. And as Leah said, there is a long way to go for it. But you see, in my professional career, I was a scientist, an engineer in artificial intelligence. And if we would behave in a way like so many Aikido people behaved in separating from each another, there would have been no progress. And people learn from each another. And Aikido is just a special kind of research, but it's research. Osensei, up to his death, he said, I didn't finish it yet. And he never formulated a curriculum which was fixed. It was open. And he still developed it further on in his final years. And therefore, this is the heritage we have. And this makes it very exciting because everybody can explore it and not only make his or her own experiences, but his or her own interpretations. You are Aikido, so it belongs to you. It doesn't belong to any other one. It doesn't belong to your teacher. It doesn't belong to your friends who are practicing Aikido. It's your Aikido. And you stand for it. And this is the interesting part.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you.